As the pandemic rages on, one industry has surely benefited with changing consumer behavior: e-commerce. Case in point, the recent 11/11 sale here in the Philippines. Let's now speak to Petros Carbonell, the head of business development at Lazada Philippines. Petros, good morning, and thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning, Rain, and I'm very happy to be here. Thank you for inviting us.
We're happy that you're here, too. Now, we saw the 11/11 sales of Alibaba, the parent of Lazada, nearly double its 2019 figure. How did Lazada do in sales, especially in the first hour of 11/11? Did big-ticket items sell, or still more of the essentials? And were there any surprises in the products that sold the most, or something unique to the Philippines' 11/11 sales, perhaps?
Well, the 11/11 sale was amazing. Year on year, we see growth in our number of sellers and customers who participate in our 11/11. But the key thing here is that the participation rate. We had a record number of sellers being able to sell, most of them MSMEs, and also a record number of buyers buying on our platform. At the core of it, Lazada, we want to empower sellers, diba, to sell, and this 11/11 sale is actually doing that. So we're very happy with what happened during 11/11.
You're talking about participation rate. So how many buyers did go into the website and look for things or add to cart, and how much of it translated into actual sales?
Well, we saw millions of Filipinos going online. We saw a lot of them converting to sales. And we have yet to check the numbers right now, but we're confirming them all. But safe to say that we have never seen this amount of sales and amount of buyers and amount of sellers ever since in a single day in the whole Philippines.
Was it double? Would it be double what you had from last month?
Generally our business, like, is versus pre-COVID, is grew 2.5 times. So after the temporarily suspending our operations due to ECQ and lockdown measures, we saw actually a 15-time increase in essential goods ordered on the platform. And in terms of growth versus 2019, at least, we see an uplift of 2 times the number of buyers and orders.
Understood. The economy hit hard by the pandemic. What does this kind of sales turnout tell you about consumer behavior and spending habits? Does it show that people really don't have as much purchasing power as before, or they still actually do? Did buyers hold off on buying until they received their vouchers or could spend their coins or chatted with the sellers first?
Well, pandemic generally accelerated the existing trends that are there already. So more people going online, they bring their habits online as well. We see more adopters of online bills payment, more purchases being made online. We also see people looking at platforms like Lazada as more than just transactional. We see them looking at it as a lifestyle destination, and they're doing a lot of discovery, product discovery, on live stream, in-app games, and more appreciation of that personalization function that we have on Lazada.
Mm-hmm. Well, what kind of online selling, meanwhile? What kind of tactics did buyers respond to? Was it the foreign and local celebrity ads? Was it the phone alerts, live streaming sellers, or still the price of the items, the discounts, or payment method? What made them add to cart?
Well, it's a mix of things. No? It's everything that the small things that we did, big and small things. Definitely, the local and international celebrities help get attention. But there's a wide range of MSMEs. The wide range of assortment is there. The prices, of course, are very good. And all the forms of payment methods that are available to them all helped add to cart.
What about logistics? Are you still experiencing a lag in the delivery of items? And where is it coming from? How did you solve the slowdown or address the greater demand in items for delivery? Did you see courier services step up in the number of delivery staff and service hours? We've seen the rise of micro-fulfillment centers and 30-minute deliveries. Did it really change the game?
Well, first on our part, on logistics, yes, recently the situation has already improved. So we're experiencing high levels of delivery rates within the committed lead time. And in terms of like the other platforms, of course, it's improved a lot. So technology is coming in. A lot of traditional logistics companies have already also invested in their systems. We've also invested a lot in terms of our logistics and our warehouse and everything. And I think everything that's happened has helped improve everything about e-commerce.
Mm-hmm. Well, how do you address concerns of an allegedly low resolution rate on complaints against online sellers for products when they are, for example, defective or deceptive, fraudulent fakes, or even involve illegal drugs? How much of these problematic transactions comprise total transactions?
Well, we believe that the problem is relatively small when compared to the volume of online transactions. But Lazada will support the Philippine government's commitment to build a trusted e-commerce economy that protects both consumers and businesses. And we will continue to collaborate with the legislators and other government agencies on the development of an internet transactions law that equitably benefits relevant stakeholders such as platforms, consumers, MSMEs, and everybody who sells online on these platforms.
Is there any provision on that proposed law that Lazada might be against?
Well, at least what we believe is that to make this work, it takes both the public and private sector investing in terms of their time, their efforts, and everything. So we think we, in our collaborations with the different government agencies and the legislators, we think we will come up with a compromise and that's a good thing for everybody.
By how much would taxing online transactions of sales platforms affect Lazada? Do you think it might lead to closure, at least in the Philippine market?
Right now, Lazada is actually doing taxations already. So every sale on Lazada has its own, we're paying VAT. We also encourage all our sellers to pay the income tax and everything. So I think for the taxations that are proposed, we think that we're already compliant, at least on Lazada side, as well as a lot of our sellers already.
Mm-hmm. What about the sellers? This seems to them to be fully embracing e-commerce. What kind of growth in the number of sellers and inventory did you experience? Were the last minute growth because of 11/11? And what assurances made them transition to online selling? And because of this, what growth in the e-economy are you looking to see in the near term?
So we're very bullish about the growth of the economy. So we think all the buyers who already started to buy on Lazada and other platforms will remain an e-commerce customer. So what we're seeing is that, especially with the drive of 11/11, we saw a lot of sellers rushing to get their sales online. We saw a record number for new millionaires. We saw a record number of people buying. We saw a record number of sellers being able to sell. And we saw a lot of success stories coming both from brands, big brands, and as well as MSMEs on 11/11. And now we think that a lot of our resources, tools, and market access that we give to businesses are very helpful for a lot of businesses out there.
So Petrus, how does this figure into the WorldBEX? Of course, these are all tools that sellers and buyers can take advantage of for WorldBEX's wired event for the benefit of ABS-CBN Foundation on November 20th. How does it figure?
So we're actually going to help a lot of MSMEs. So we encourage everybody to join WorldBEX. If they join, we can also help support and assure them that when they come on the platform, we will be able to help them. So we have a 90-day incubation program that's ready for them once they come online. We also have some service marketplace packages that is ready for everybody to avail of when they come online.
All right, Petrus Carbonell of Lazada, thank you so much for joining us and sharing your thoughts with us today. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Ring.